Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here and welcome back to another video. So guys, in today's video, we'll be discussing the Adobe article that Todoist and Adobe put together about their brand new redesign. Now the article was put together by Mark Schendker on the Adobe team, and the idea of the article is to Q&A Anna Fiera from the Todoist team. Now, to just give you a bit of background on Todoist, Todoist is a company that is 11 years old now. They are the creators of Todoist and Twist. Now, Todoist we will be speaking about today mainly because they have an upcoming redesign. So their last major redesign was in September 2015, and I remember it quite well because I was quite excited. Now, the redesign included a new brand logo, as well as a new web application and color schemes with iOS and Android apps to follow. Now, it's been some time since that redesign, and of course, Todoist have announced that they will be producing a new redesign by the end of the year. So in today's video, I wanted to dive into some of the things they've stated in this Adobe article, as well as giving you my personal opinions of what I think the new Todoist redesign will look like. So, over the last year, what have we seen with the Todoist updates? We haven't seen a great deal. We've mainly seen core experience updates. The Todoist team have really been focusing, maybe the last 1 to 2 years, on making sure the experience is stable versus design focused. We've seen applications like Cultured Code and even TickTick try and take over Todoist in the design element of their experience, and this is mainly due to Todoist's focus on keeping the experience strong and core for those using it. So inside of the article, Anna actually gets asked a host of different questions, and I've picked out a few quotes that sort of draw my attention. So she says, "This year we're doing design exploration to give Todoist a totally fresh and updated look. But the redesign will go much deeper than that. We're rethinking some of Todoist's core foundations with pretty much everything on the table." So that's quite an interesting statement there. It does give cadence to the fact that Todoist will be sort of re-exploring how Todoist is structured, which I quite like. I think a company of its age and its size really do need to think about how they can leapfrog some of the more open experiences out there. The next mention Anna states is, it's one of those situations where to update the UX, we have to do a major changes to the back end. It's all interconnected, and it's a huge undertaking. Now, of course, as we mentioned, the last year has been a lot of that focus of improving the back end, improving the core experiences before the users get a full redesign. Now, she also states that they're making our applications simpler and faster to use, which is something that I've highlighted over the last couple of months. Maybe it's because I'm using my iPhone 6 Plus, but I believe the iOS and Android app seems to be a little slower, less gesture-based than the likes of Things 3. She states, this redesign also includes a highly controversial change in the menu from tabs to collapsible navigation. She mentions that collapsing the menus for less visual clutter and better focus. She also mentioned that with that in mind, we're redesigning our empty screens, not just to make the app more delightful to use, but also provide helpful contextual tips to that lead them to the next step in getting more organized and in control of their tasks. She states, during the first 2 months of the Todoist foundations, we're also contacted our most active users and both premium and free, scheduling interviews and sending out surveys. They also stated, this approach fits our 6-week work cycles and makes it easier to get early feedback on changes and iterate or even consider their value altogether. So I think this was overall a really good interview by Anna from the Todoist team. It's definitely worth checking out. I'll include the link in the description. Now, I wanted to give you my opinions and thoughts on what I think the redesign will look like. So first off, I do believe Todoist does need a facelift in their experience. The experience has gotten a little bit static, and I probably would have given them until March 2019 until I would have started complaining as a sort of cutoff point, because I believe they do need a refresh. It's been 3 years since they've done a big sort of redesign. So when do I think this experience will be released? I believe it will be out in the late September and October time. I'm sort of erring on that side, but they could push it out all the way till the end of December It's totally up to how their development team are working on it. So when they mention core foundations, I do believe they will try to resurface how you use Todoist. My sort of focus, I think, will be mainly on Todoist providing a Kanban experience like they've done in their Windows Boards app, or a card experience, allowing you to have a bit more of a card-based to-do list experience. I do think as well they'll be introducing less static windows. For example, I noticed there's a comment window, it does feel a little bit static, and I feel like they're going to add some additions to that to make it a bit more like the likes of TickTick's comment window being a bit more interactive. Now, the statement about the menu bars and navigation, I do think they're going to make this more like Things3 or Notion, allowing you to swipe away your experience, giving you this clutter-free, strict focus experience, giving you simplicity over complexity. I also believe on that you will be able to modify your menu in more of an interactive style. So for example, let's say you want to hide your inbox, or even you don't necessarily want your Today tab there, maybe they'll be able to schedule that off. I do think they'll introduce two new apps during this time, the iOS and Android applications that are more gesture focused, card based, that take on the likes of Things3 in this experience. I do think this will be a leapfrog of Things3 in its design, and I think that with its Todoist stability, I think that will make it a huge winner. Now, do I think there's going to be a new logo or brand? I don't think so. I think their Todoist logo works really, really well. I mean, 3 years, I guess, is a good period of time, but maybe they will change it, but I really don't think they need to. So I wanted to shout to a few mentions, people discussing this already. Back in, I believe it was May time, Jackson Hayes on his Medium posted an article about why he wants a new Todoist redesign. That was quite a while ago, and I believe it's more relevant than ever right now. But it's great that Todoist have announced this. A lot of companies just keep quiet, and a lot of people will just move from Todoist just because they haven't seen a redesign. Now, the likes of Kevin Aguilar, I really apologize for the pronunciation, on Dribbble back in July posted this awesome redesign, and I think it's a great example of what I think the cards will look like inside of Todoist. Of course, I think that it might not be this sort of blocky, because Todoist is more of a list experience, and if you have a long list, this might be a bit daunting to look at, but it's definitely worth taking a look at it, because I think that's how they're going to approach it. Now, if you want to see some reactions to the new Todoist redesign, there is a Reddit thread below which you can go and dive into. I'm going to be jumping into the comments there and giving my sort of opinion, as well as posting this video too. So just to round off, I do think Todoist is launching this at the perfect time. Of course, the likes of like Evernote, obviously they have it redesigned fully in like 5 or 6 years. Obviously they've had minor cross-platform redesigns, but nothing of this scale like Todoist does from a full redesign perspective. And that's really made them suffer. So I think this is the optimum time. As I said, if it came to March 2019 and there wasn't one there, I probably would say, okay, it's a bit too static. Now, do remember that Todoist have been focusing on their other team communication called Twist a lot. So that's been one of their main focuses as they've been getting started. So they've probably divided a lot of their attention and time into it. So do bear that in mind. And do remember that that's going to be a huge play in the future. So make sure to check out Twist. So as I said, I think that it's important for users not to necessarily rely on redesigns, but I definitely think this is coming at the perfect time for Todoist. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed my review on the new Todoist redesign that's coming very soon. Let me know in the comments what you guys think. It'd be great to hear your own opinion of how you think the new look will come. You can even include links to maybe designs that you've seen, or if you're a designer, mock up something, but it'd be really great to hear some of your opinions. Anyway, guys, a huge thank you for stopping by today. If you are not subscribed, hit subscribed. Do hit that like button as well if you enjoyed this video, because it helps it to be more shared around the whole YouTube network. Anyway, guys, a huge thank you for stopping by, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers.